Welcome back, everyone. This is a continuation of the Smallmouth Bass series on Lake Erie. Today we'll be covering the reef complex on the western basin of Lake Erie. It's located just north of Camp Perry and in Port Clinton, Ohio. This can be a pretty good area at times for smallmouth, and I wanted to make sure I covered it in this series in case you want to go explore this area and try to find some fish. I will start this segment by covering the firing range area. Those are the cans, the yellow cans that you see on the screen here. These cans mark a restricted area off of Camp Perry. So what this does is they close this area during operations at Camp Perry. They fire short range and long range weapons at Camp Perry during training for the military and the national matches, which lasts a few months in the summertime. So just be aware of this area. The way you know it's closed is Camp Perry will fly a flag off. There's a pier off of Camp Perry right here. They will fly a flag that closes the zones. There's an inner danger zone that you see marked here and an outer danger zone. A lot of times that outer danger zone isn't closed unless they're shooting long-range heavy weapons. The other way you can find out when that area is going to be open or closed is just call Camp Perry. They might give you a schedule the next few days out of whenever you plan on fishing. Also, you can monitor VHF. They will broadcast on VHF if the firing range is closed or will be closing. Just a word of caution, if you are out there and they have that red flag up and you aren't paying attention and you're in that area when it's closed, they'll chase you off with a boat. They have a boat that patrols these cans, so just be aware of that. Okay, next we will go over the launches that are closest to this area. And the area I'm talking about is basically these red lines. And I will cover West Sister today too, but basically these red lines, this whole area is full of rocks, reefs, shoals, stuff like that. So the two closest launches, or three closest launches really, are the Toussaint River. I think there's Beef Creek Marina in there for a small fee you can launch there, come straight out the mouth of the river. Looks like just a couple miles in there. You can be on the reefs. Also, you have Fenwick Marina right here, or Turtle Creek, whatever you want to call it, over here. And also Wild Wings Marina right here. All have close access to the reef complex. And then if you don't want to mess with those, you can just launch at Catawba or the Portage River. Just be aware it is a longer run from there to the reef complex or West Sister, wherever you're wanting to fish. Okay, let's get right into the fishing here. Now, I don't have a ton of experience out here, but I have spent a few months on different years fishing this area and have caught some nice fish and pinpointed some areas. So I'm only going to cover today, I think, five reefs, four reefs in West Sister. So five total spots. So how I'm going to cover this is I'm going to zoom in on, now the four reefs that I've fished are Round Reef, Toussaint Reef, Crib Reef, and Niagara Reef. Just because they offer the biggest structure area to kind of look around for fish. So how I'm going to cover these reefs and explain how to fish these is, I'm going to zoom in on Crib Reef because it has a lot of features, and I can show you guys what areas to target at what times of the year and how to approach fishing one of these places. Cause it's kind of like fishing Kelly Shoal or Gull Shoal or something like that. It'll be a lot similar, but I'll still go over it on how to fish some of this stuff. So in the springtime, if you're fishing pre-spawn, obviously you're going to be fighting all the walleye guys out here, because this is where the walleye and smallmouth spawn out here. So the walleye will spawn before the smallmouth, but you will, if you're out here early enough, pre-smallmouth spawn, you can catch some really nice fish out here that are staging. And they're kind of up there feeding in the area, pre-spawn, March time frame I'm talking about, early April, when the walleye are heavy up on these reefs. There's going to be some smallmouth mixed in there. I don't typically fish for smallmouth during that time, only because there's so many walleye out there and it's hard to pick them out of the pack. Now you will catch a stray one walleye fishing or something out here, but I know they're there and I've seen them caught and I've caught them myself during a walleye spawn, but it's tough just to single them out while fishing because there's so many walleye in the area. Now, when I typically fish for them, it's June or after, when that water starts to warm up and these fish are back off spawning, and they are targeting bait out here. They're roaming, looking for bait. So on crib reef, for an example, I'm going to target June. Now this is just June or after. So I'm going to target the edges of this reef. In June, I'm going to focus on 13 to 15 foot of water in this main area. They're going to be hanging on these contours. Now the side's going to depend on wind direction, current, and which side the bait is on. So typically what I'm going to do is I'm going to scan this reef first, try to find some bait schools, then fish that 13 to 15 foot water in June, early July. After that, after the water starts really warming up, I'm going to get way off the side of this thing. Now in the early morning, they might be in that 13 to 15 foot range and you might be able to catch them on a drop shot or tube or something like that. But as 11 o'clock hits, noon hits, gets real hot outside, these fish are going to slide off the side of here and hang out. If they're not feeding, they're going to hang out. So what I'm going to cover that 18 to 22 foot. If you can find rocks in 22 foot out here, sometimes it's difficult, but it can be done. But I'm going to find that last contour where sand meets that rock. So, and this area is kind of tough because there's rock piles that aren't even marked on here. You can see them kind of marked out here, but there's rocks and stuff all over the place out here. So if you can find off this main shoal or even this shoal, this is kind of a secondary shoal right here off of crib. If you can find that last contour where those rocks meet that sand, just barren wasteland sand, where those big boulders meet that, a lot of times those fish are going to be sitting on that sand side of the rocks. So, or on that last boulder before it meets the sand. They're kind of out there. They want structure, but they want to be able to be on the sand as well. It's kind of hard to explain. I don't know. That's just where I found them. So that would be your midsummer to late summer pattern out here. And that you can replicate that pretty much on all four of those reefs that I mentioned, around Toussaint, Crib, and Niagara. That's been my go-to pattern there. And you can replicate that on these other reefs too. Locust, pretty popular. Cone, Flat Rock, Little Pick. Any of these reefs, you can replicate that stuff. Now, a lot of these smaller ones might hold fish as well. You may not find, you know, a school of 25 fish, but you might find one or two nice ones on some of these little known unmarked rock piles, and scanning the area with your side scan is going to help all that. So if you can find some isolated boulders or something like that, obviously that's going to be a good spot as well. Okay, let me go over a little bit about baits out here. Now, early summer, like I said, when I might venture out here, is swim baits, drop shot, and tubes. That's my three main right there. Now, I've never used, now I know some of those, a few years ago, they had that big super tournament, FLW combo event, whatever the heck that thing was. And a lot of guys were out here using Ned rigs. I'm sure they work. I just haven't personally used them. So I use those more towards over the islands. But my main three are swim baits, drop shot, and tubes. Now, on a drop shot, I like a longer leader out here on the reefs. I use a 12 to 18 inch leader. Kind of get that bait way up off the bottom so those fish have something to hone in on. Just me personally, whatever works for you, just leader lengthwise, just use it. I like a small Erie darter out here, 3 inch. I won't use anything bigger than 3 inch out here. Just personal experience. They like the smaller baits. Maybe that's the bait in the area's size that they're eating. Now I do use a 4 inch tube, but the last inch is that skirt. So your main body is only 3 inches. So it's smaller body on it, but the tail is an inch. I think that's it on the reefs. Okay, we'll slide up to West Sister here. This is a pretty straightforward island of fish. Now these fish are local to the area. They're gonna roam these shoals and rocks out here on the reef complex and then wander up to West Sister and back down, and they might go out to one of these wrecks and hang out for a little bit. So these fish move around. So don't think if I give you two or three spots on West Sister, don't think you're gonna pull up them spots and catch 20 pounds. You might, but you still got to look for them. These fish move around like crazy. So on West Sister, there's three spots that I like to fish. I like to fish, obviously, the obvious spot, this long point. And there's a wreck on this point, too, way up shallow. But on Google Maps, I think you can see that point. Yep, there it is. So there's a big, long sand point on there. There's a few rocks on it, but I like to fish that point way off the end of it deep. Like I said, I'm not even venturing out this way till after June and beyond. So I'm fishing way out deep off this point is where I'm fishing. 15 foot in the morning, sliding out to 25 tops. I don't typically fish deeper than 25 out here at West Sister. That's the first spot, obvious spot. You can see it on your Navionics. The next spot is at southwest corner. It's kind of the same structure, just a steeper bank. So there's a real nice underwater point here. It can be very good if the fish are there. Still have to look for them and find them, but Same baits I'm using down here, I'm using up here at West Sister. So I'm going to use a swim bait, drop shot, or tube. The next spot is on the northern end here. You're going to see a series of underwater irregularities, I guess I'll call them. See these little outlying contours in between here and on the ends of these. I found big schools of fish hanging right in this area. So I don't know what it is about it. Now I know the current comes through here like this. Maybe they're sitting on the edge of those contours catching bait as they're coming by. I don't know. I don't know why they sit there. But twice now, I've found some real nice fish right there in that area. And that may be because they're coming down from Canada or coming across from West Reef. I don't know. But anyway, that's a pretty good spot. That's where I would start. If any of y'all head up there, I would start on that north side. Maybe scan that whole north side. Try to side scan some fish. Look around on your live scope. But those three main baits is what I'm using up here as well. Swim baits, drop shot, tubes. Now on a swim bait, I like the 3.3 Kytec. I forgot to go over that. Yeah, 3.3 Kytec in either silver or they make a light green pumpkin. Man, I don't know the color off the top of my head. I'm trying to think. Yeah, I don't know the color off the top of my head. But anyway, it's like a light green pumpkin or that silver or white silver bait. And a 3.3 with just a regular ball head's fine. And what I do is I cast that out. I'm going to let it hit the rocks and I'm going to slowly reel it across those rocks. Real slow with a spinning rod. And that's how I'm swimming that swim bait. But it can be very effective. If you're seeing them on your live scope and they won't eat a drop shot, they won't eat a tube, they won't eat a Ned rig, that can be very effective if they want some moving bait. Okay, so that concludes this video, guys. Make sure you like and subscribe. Leave a comment if I missed anything or you want a specific question about this area answered or any of the areas that we've covered already. And all right, have a good day. Thanks.